I'm Ian Bartholomew, and I'm going to talk to you today about what is reliability. One of the most important things about developing meaningful SLOs is defining a meaningful SLI first. And the most critical feature of a meaningful SLI is that it measures the reliability of a system or a service. But what is reliability? Reliability is the measurement of time that the given service is able to perform its intended function from the user's point of view. We want to look at the service from the user's point of view and ask ourselves what the user expects and needs in order to use the service. If the service is not performing according to what the user wants, needs, or expects, they will have a suboptimal experience or not be able to use the service at all. However, reliability also gets confused with uptime and availability, so it's essential to define and disambiguate these terms. Uptime is the measurement of the time the individual service is running, while availability measures the time a service can respond to requests from users. We can think about reliability as the measurement of how well a service is performing, including availability and uptime. A service can be up but not available, such as if an application is running but a network issue is preventing requests from getting to the service. However, the converse wouldn't be true because in order for it to be available, it would need to be up. And a service can't be reliable if it's not up or available. But what's vital to remember is that the reliability is a user-focused metric. And so in addition to uptime and availability, we need to define other critical characteristics of the service from the user's perspective. To start defining what the reliability of our service, we should start thinking about specific and measurable metrics that the user expects and needs in order to have a good experience. Things like latency, like how long it takes for a response to come, or data correctness, is the data in a format that the user is expecting and is it correct? For example, for some services, it may be critical to have responses in less than 500 milliseconds, but for others, it may not. There are several things that do not directly impact the user journey that we don't need to track unless it immediately impacts the user and their ability to use the service successfully. These are things like CPU, memory, or bandwidth saturation. These are things that wouldn't necessarily have an impact on the user experience, so it's not necessary to have these in your reliability definition by default. Most likely, these would get tracked as part of other measurements and metrics. For example, suppose a given service's memory is nearly consumed. In that case, the latency might increase since the requests are starting to stack up, so it may be enough just to track the latency rather than the latency and memory usage. This way, we can reduce the number of things we are tracking and only focus on meaningful metrics. This is also true for other metrics that we would want to track, such as the uptime and availability of the service. These could be included in higher order checks. For example, if we check the expected format of a response, such as if the JSON payload is in the expected shape, a successful response would assume that the service is both up and available. To start measuring the reliability of your service, start at the most basic and work outwards. At the most basic level, the service should be up and running, so we want to measure the uptime. Most services also need to be available and respond to user requests, so we'd want to measure the availability, such as, are we able to get any response from the service? Moving beyond that, we would want to make sure that we're serving successful responses, so we should track the number of responses that do not have a 500 status code. If the service is running a batch or a cron job, you might want to measure the number of successful runs. Additionally, once we've done that, we'd want to see how many of these can be consolidated into single metrics. The important part is to put yourself into the user's position, understand what they need to have a good experience, and base your reliability metrics on that. Doing so will then lead to meaningful SLIs and meaningful SLOs. Thank you.